I think the way I remember it is that Karen and I literally sat down for coffee to talk about what I wanted to do my thesis on.
Well, it was a series of conversations.
I sort of had this idea kind of sitting in the back of my head, and so we just asked a very basic question
about developmental biology.
Whether or not bacteria may or may not influence the development of the pancreas and pancreatic beta cells.
The answer could have been yes or it could have been no, and the answer was yes, that there was an impact on development. And then that immediately provoked the next question.
Can we influence the development of those pancreatic
insulin-producing beta cells?
So, and we found that we could.
You know, we just kept on following this lead when we learned that there were specific bacteria that could do this. And then Jennifer asked, well, are they secreting anything that could do this?
And so to kind of get at that question, we used the very simple tools that we have available in the lab, which is the zebrafish model organism.
Then she started, you know, just drilling down into asking, well, what is this material?
Identity of this product.
And so that gave us a clue that this is likely to be a secreted protein involved.
And so then we had a list of possible candidates.
It was about 165 proteins.
The genome, 163. We narrowed that huge list down to one possible candidate.
You know, when she told me this, I was entirely skeptical. I was like, there's no way that this could, you know, have worked out this well.
We named it beta cell expansion factor A, or BEF-A.
Hey, Beth.
You know, it was just a remarkable day when she put that on sterile germ-free fish, and all of a sudden, beta cells just exploded. It was so crystal clear from that image that this was a big deal.
Not because we're curing diabetes or anything like that.
But this protein has the potential for being developed into a therapeutic for type 1 diabetes.
You know, if this can help people, we want it to help people.
Realizing its therapeutic potential.
For the first time, we're showing that a protein produced by a bacteria is actually capable of acting on this very important and essential cell population of the pancreas, the beta cells.